equipment plays a role. One of the hats I wear is as a vice president of NOCSI, which certifies football helmets and other athletic equipment. And there's no doubt that helmets are better today than they were 10 years ago, and 10 years ago they were better than 20 years ago. But helmets don't prevent the majority of concussions, and probably never will, because they do quite a good job with regard to those focal linear forces, like a stick over your head. And they do a quite poor job of attenuating the forces of rotatory impacts, like snapping your head from a blow to the side of the head. This is a normal nerve cell. You have the dendrites, you have the nerve cell, and you have the axon. And the signal arrives at the nerve cell, it's transmitted to it, it's transmitted along the axon, and then with neurotransmitters, they are released that then propagates the message on to the next neuron in the chain. When you have a concussive injury, you have this metabolic chaotic event where the potassium that normally is inside the cell goes outside the cell. So it goes from the inside to the outside extracellular space. When these ions rush out of the cell, it allows the positively charged calcium ions to replace them inside the cell. But these calcium ions shut down the ATP, which is the energy pump that's needed to pump them out and pump the potassium back in. So it leads to this metabolic dysfunction. And it's at this stage that the cell is alive, but the cell is not functioning. And if you stress it, either physically or cognitively, you can tip the balance and cause this cell to die. And that's why the hallmark of concussion management is physical and cognitive rest until symptoms have cleared, or at least gotten a great deal better. And then with most concussions, after a period of time, the potassium ions will get pumped back inside, the calcium ions will get pumped out, the neurotransmitters will be put back on. So after a period of time, you have a normal functioning situation and there's no demonstrable injury that can be demonstrated. And so no matter how much they're improved, they're not going to dramatically decrease the most injurious of all accelerated forces, the rotational ones. So I think it's great to keep working to build a better helmet, and I don't think any of that work should ever slow down. And I think it's great educating that new helmets are better than old helmets, and let's definitely recondition helmets frequently and eliminate helmets that have been in the market for 10 years, period. But I don't think helmets are the solution. They're great for eliminating skull fracture. They're great for reducing the incidence of acute intracranial bleeds, the subdurals, but they haven't done much for concussions.
This excerpt is brought to you by the Massachusetts School of Law, the leader of reform in legal education and a leader in multimedia education for the public. To view the full interview and for a full listing of MSL's programs, log on to mslaw.edu.